But eventually I started to get to talk to the DJs, and one guy asked me, a guy called Paul Steady, who runs a TV production company now. In fact, he's just made a brilliant documentary that was on Channel 5 called The Body Donors, where people donate their body to medical science. He made that, and he's made loads of stuff. And he said to me, well, do you want to come and sit in on my show on Sunday afternoon? So I did. And my dad drove me to Radio Air, made him wait outside because it wasn't cool for your dad to come in the radio station with you. And I went in, I remember him showing me how the turntables worked and the cartridges. I queued up on the turntable, Toy Boy by Sunita. It's 1997. And that'll come in handy, that knowledge. It might come up in a pop quiz. 1997, Sunita's Toy Boy. And you could get a beer token for it, which then could win, you know, the rest of it. So I want tax on your beer tokens. sorry. And then he said to me, I'm going to be moving to Sunday mornings doing the breakfast show soon, so would you like to come in on a Sunday morning? I said, well, I don't know if I can get my dad to pick me. My dad won't bring, well, my dad did bring me in actually for the first few times. But then Paul said to me, I'll pick you up on a morning. And he did, he went out of his way, came to Barnsley, picked me up, brought me to the radio station, and I was in the building.
Yeah.
And I was in, I'd got my foot in the door, it's late 1987, and I managed to catch the back end, I was 12, I managed to catch the back end of how radio, in some respects, used to be using vinyl and cartridges, there was no computers, we weren't even running CDs.
Right.
We just got two CD players, but they were for like a special Saturday night show,
yeah.
All CD. Now we just do all vinyl shows, don't we, funnily enough. So that's how I kind of got in, and I worked my way up and just annoyed the living daylights out of the DJs.
Okay, so we're going to listen to a little bit of you. This is you being the annoying kid, and this is you calling up Radio Air, is that correct?
Yeah, Radio Air. I got through to a guy who did the evening show called Carl Kingston.
Okay.
And but I don't know, we were still on a dial phone at this time. I've not progressed
dialing
quickly
at this point. This is 1986.
Alright, let's have a listen.
So, Radio Air, pop computer. First round of the pop computer. First of the final two for this week. Hi, Simon.
Hello.
It's Simon Hirst coming in from Wilford Road in Athersley North. How are you this evening?
Alright.
Alright, how old are you, Simon, by the way?
11.
Yeah. Okay, what are your interests in, Simon? Any hobbies, stamp collecting, anything like that?
No, records.
Records?
Yeah.
Do you actually buy records? Is that what you mean? Yeah. How many have you got?
About
300.
About 300?
I've been collecting since 1982. You've been collecting since 82? Crikey, that's a lot of records for someone your age, isn't it?
Mm-hmm.
Can you remember the first record you bought then?
No, I can't.
You can't remember? Shaking Stevens.
Shaking Stevens.
Which one?
For those that have been living under a rock or don't know, that's me, I changed my gender. I wish my voice still was that high pitched, to be fair.
You sounded quite shy there, so what, you were 11?
Yeah, because I think I was ringing without mum and dad knowing. So, because I was always getting told off music phones, so I was upstairs, probably under my duvet.
Yeah.
Scared that mum and dad are going, I'm going to get done again for being on phone, because I was constantly ringing radio stations. Radio 1 didn't have a ring phone number. So I could never ring Radio 1, but if they did, I mean, they did progress to 01716374343. And if you want to send a fax, it was 01716372476.
Okay, good knowledge. Alright, so, Radio Bedroom, we've done like the amateur kind of stuff, and then the big time, when did the big time?
So being a tech op, and we used to run a show on a Saturday night, which was on tape, so it's my job to play this show out later. I think it wasn't America's Choice with Benny Brown, it was something else. There was a, maybe the Eurochart Hot 100 with Pat Sharp off at Funhouse. And I think we ran that, it was on a Saturday night, and it ran 10 till 1. And the guy who did the overnight show after me called in sick. So I rang the boss at Radio Air and said, Neil's rung in, he can't make it tonight. Who do I ring to get to cover him? I need to let you know. And this was like an hour before. I said, well, this is the big time. It's your go, you're on.
Wow.
So I did overnight.
And Radio Air?
On Radio Air, in the studio that obviously I rang up as a kid. Mm. I'm finally on the air. I finally got a cover shift. And it's in an hour. I've not prepped for it. I had no idea that I was going to do this. They just chucked me on.
Okay.
So, and yeah.
So and we've got a bit, we've got some of that.
There's
right?
some audio of my first ever Lincoln Radio Air, which you, if you, the first time you do a show on the radio, you want to nail it, don't you? You want to get it absolutely spot on. You don't want to make any mistakes whatsoever.
Let's see how you did.
So I went to Metro, Charles Squire. I went up for a chat at Swalwell. Nothing ever came of it, but met him. Just going into Metro, I was like, oh my God, this thing was huge. In fact, the thing you just drive on Capital was on.
Martin Lowe's?
No, just drive on Capital now, I forgot his name, I was just gone for
the moment. Oh, Greg Burns.
Greg Burns was on. Greg was on. And I remember driving
okay,
Lowe's,
yeah,
it was about 93. Maybe 94 actually, so, and I sent a tape to Minster FM and I got this letter from Paul Carrington, who was the PD then, who's on Pulse 2 now, and one of my best friends in the world. And he wrote me a letter saying that you're not exactly what I'm looking for, good looking, you search your work. And I was sitting at the edge of my bed in radio bedroom, looking at this letter, looking at my phone. Well, it wasn't my phone, it was my parents' phone. I'd run a cable under door from their bedroom to my bedroom. I used to get told off for it all the time, see me in phones. And I just went over to my phone, picked up the phone, rang Minster, asked to speak to Paul Carrington. I got through. I said, I got your letter saying, you know what I'm looking for. You know, I'm not what you're looking for. I said, but I am what you're looking for. He went, no, 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 honestly, I remember your tape. You're just a little bit too young. You know what I'm looking for. I said, yeah, but I am what you're looking for. He went, no, you're not, and I'm looking for someone just a little bit older, a bit more mature, but seriously, good luck in what you do. I said, no, I am what you're looking for. So he says, well, if you think you are, come and do a live demo now. So I've got him a box on over, I drove a helpful leather down the A64, I abided by the speed limit, of course. Honestly, that thing would go over 70 miles an hour, so I couldn't break speed limit anyway. In fact, it's 60 on the A64, isn't it? Got to Minster, he gave me the music log from the job who was on the hour before, gave me a pile of CDs, stuck a reel of tape on the machine, pressed play and record, he says, do an hour. I did like 40 minutes, he came in, he stopped the tape, he rewound it to the start, listened to two links. I said, why didn't you do that on your demo? You're on Sunday. And I decked Sunday night. Pat O'Banton from Baby Come Back was number one. And I said, thanks to Foxy. Yeah, so that was my first. I was coming for a guy called Alex Camp, and yeah, I did some evenings, and then picked up a load of cover work.
Yeah.
Did overnights again, because I was used to staying a big load to all you truckers. So they stuck in overnights, and they had some kind of memory module thing on overnights, where you played like loads of oldies stuff, and I love old music, so I was like in my elements. And then they gave me a daytime show, they gave me 11 till 3, but I was making ads, writing ads, carting ads, scheduling music, doing 11 till 3 for like 25 quid a day, which to me then I'd won the lottery. But I was spinning too many plates and I kept getting written warnings. I think it was the only radio station that gave you 7 written warnings. And eventually I had a big bust up and my friends were going on holiday to Magaluf. So I went to Magaluf and stayed in Magaluf for a little bit, got a job at BCM's nightclub. Yeah, I stayed up there, got my record. A couple of other friends were coming out, so they brought some of my records out with me. And yeah, I stayed there, but I'd sent some demos to Metro again, and Giles Squire had passed that on to Steve Martin at Pulse. Moyles had just been fired, James Cridland, James Andrews, Media UK, Radio Futurologist was covering evenings, they needed someone to take over full time. I got evenings on the Pulse.
Wow.
And I loved it. I loved doing evenings. It's my favourite. I think my favourite show that I've ever done is the evening show on the Pulse. I just adored it. Which one?
You can be any.